हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल। माइसेल्फ रश्मिता जेना, लेक्चर इन कंप्यूटर साइंस, यूएन ऑटोनॉमस कॉलेज, अरसपुर कटक। सो टुडे सेशन विल लर्न ऑन द टॉपिक दैट द बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑन नेटवर्क सिक्योरिटी और इंफॉर्मेशन सिक्योरिटी। एज वी नो, नेटवर्क इज द कलेक्शन ऑफ कंप्यूटर और नोड्स। दैट मीन्स व्हेन the what network security came, that means we provide security to the data over the network system. So let's learn some basic concept of network security or information security or information security, right? So the first concept in the network security or information security is your plain text. So what is plain text? Plain text means which is easily readable by the user, or you can say that is your normal text, or you can say the readable format of the text. So plain text is what? That is a normal text or readable format of a text which will be easily recognized or which will be easily readable by the user, right? Then next concept is your ciphertext. Next concept is your ciphertext. Ciphertext is what? It is quite opposite to your plain text. That means this ciphertext is in non-readable format. Okay, ciphertext is in non-readable format. This ciphertext cannot easily recognized by user. Okay, so plain text is what? That is a normal text which is easily readable by the user, or you can say the readable format of a text. Then ciphertext is what? That is a non-readable format which will be not easily recognized by the user. Okay, then when we convert a plain text to its ciphertext, that means when we convert a plain text to ciphertext, right, this is the one way to provide security to the data over the network system, right? And this process, the conversion of plain text to ciphertext, is called as encryption. Is called as encryption. So encryption is your next concept of your basic concept of network security. So it means what? That means in through the encryption process, we'll convert the readable format of a text to non-readable format, right? Encryption process is what? In this process, we will convert the readable format of a text to a non-readable format, and that process is called as the encryption, right? Then next we will know the process of decryption. Okay, decryption is the process through which the ciphertext is converted to plain text. That means the non-readable format of the text is converted to readable format, or you can say that is converted to original form of the message, and that process is called as decryption, and that text are called as the decrypted text. So decryption is the process through which the ciphertext is converted to the plain text, or you can say the non-readable format of a text is converted to its readable format or to its original text. is the process through which we convert a plain text to ciphertext. This is the one way to provide security to the data over network system. And decryption is the process through which we convert the ciphertext to the plain text, right? That means the non-readable format of a text is converted to readable format or to its original text. So this is all about your encryption, decryption, plain text and ciphertext. Then we will know cryptography and crypt analysis, right? Cryptography means the study of encryption, right? The study of encryption is known as the cryptography. Then crypt analysis is what? The study of decryption is known as the crypt analysis. The study of decryption is known as crypt analysis, and this cryptography and crypt analysis are combinedly known as cryptology. Right? That means cryptology is what? The study of encryption plus the study of decryption. The study of encryption and decryption are known as cryptology. Okay? So here we'll define cryptology is the process through which we'll encrypt the plain text to its ciphertext, and we'll decrypt the ciphertext to its plain text or to its original format. Then we will know what is key. What is key? Key is what? The group of bits are known as key. The group of bits are known as the key, which has a major role in encryption and in decryption process. Okay, so key is the group of bits which has a major role in the encryption or in decryption process. Then we will know what are the different way through which we will encrypt the plain text to its ciphertext. Okay, basically encryption is done in two ways. That is, first one is your stream cipher, second one is your block cipher, right? So what is stream cipher, what is block cipher? Stream cipher means the plain text is converted to ciphertext by bit by bit process. Bit by bit process. So block cipher is what? Again, the plain text is converted to ciphertext block by block. Okay. Block by block process. So bit by bit process means what? Suppose a plain text having this number of bit of data, and in case of stream cipher, bit by bit conversion to ciphertext means what? The first bit will be converted first to its corresponding ciphertext, then again the next bit will be converted, then next bit will be converted, then next bit will be converted. That means in case of stream cipher, bit by bit of the plain text is converted to its corresponding ciphertext. But in case of block cipher, the whole message is first divided into number of blocks, right? And this number of block size or each and every block size is depending upon the algorithm, right? According to algorithm, the original message is divided into number of block. That means the number of block size may be the block size is 64 bit or the block size may be 128 bit like this. This block size will be depends upon the algorithm, right? So in case of block cipher, the original message is first divided into number of blocks, right? Number of blocks, and the first block is converted first to its corresponding ciphertext, then the next block will be converted to its next ciphertext block, and in the similar way we will convert the n number of block to its corresponding ciphertext block. So what is the difference between stream cipher and block cipher? The stream cipher is a bit by bit process and the block cipher is a block by block process, okay? Then we will know what are the different mechanisms used in the cryptography, right? In the cryptography, there are two mechanisms are used for the encryption and decryption process. One is your symmetric cryptography system and second one is your asymmetric cryptography system. So, cryptography is done by two mechanisms, right? First one is your symmetric cryptography and second one is your asymmetric cryptography, okay? So the name says symmetric. So in case of symmetric cryptography, in both the cases we will do the encryption and decryption process, right? So first we will learn on the symmetric cryptography system. So in case of symmetric cryptography system, for encryption system, the encryption and decryption both are done and they must use a single key for both the operation. That means a single key is used for encryption process and for the decryption process. You can say the same key must be used for both encryption and decryption process, right? That means the same key used for encryption and decryption process, and this key is called as the secret key, right? This key is called as the secret key. Okay, that means when we do convert the plain text to its corresponding ciphertext, we are using one key. Suppose that key is KS, and the symmetric key is used to represent by using this symbol, that is KS. That means this key is used to convert plain text to ciphertext, as well as the same keys is used to convert the ciphertext to its plain text. That means this is the encryption process and this one is your decryption process, right? That means in case of symmetric cryptography, the same key must be used for both encryption and decryption process, and for the symmetric key, the key is used to represent by KS, okay? In case of asymmetric cryptography system, the two different key must be used for the encryption and decryption process, right? That means the two different key must be used for both the encryption and decryption process, right? That means one key is used for encryption and another key or second key is used for the decryption. That means first we must define, in asymmetric cryptography there are two keys are used. One is there public key and another one is the private key, right? Public key is used to represent by using symbol K U, and the private key is used to represent the symbol K R, right? Here for the encryption process, one key is used for encrypting the data or to convert the plain text to its corresponding ciphertext, and the second key is used for decrypting the data. Here it will be explained by using one example. Suppose take an example, and suppose there is a user 1, okay, and user 1 doing both the process, that means doing both encryption and decryption process, right? That means when user 1 encrypting, that means user 1 convert the plain text to its ciphertext by using the public key, suppose that is their K U 1, right? And similarly, when the user 1 used to convert the ciphertext to its plain text or decrypting the message, in that case that user must use the next key, that is your private key, suppose K R. You must remember one thing, in asymmetric cryptography system the key be a pair of key, the key be a pair of key for each user, for each user. That means each user have a public key and has a private key, right? Each user has a public key and has a private key. Suppose user 1 having public key KU1 and having private key KR1. Similarly, user 2 having public key KU2 and private key KR2. You must remember, when user 1 doing the process encryption and decryption, the user must use the same pair of key. That means what? In case of encryption process, if the user uses the public key KU1, then that user must use the same pair of private key. That means in that case that user must use KR1. In this case the user cannot be use KR2, right? This cannot be used if the public key is used for the user 1 and the private key must be used for the same user, that is KR1. In that case the KR2 cannot be implemented, because I already said that the key must be a pair of key for each user, right? So this is all about your asymmetric cryptography system and symmetric cryptography system, okay? Let's see some simple mechanism on encryption and decryption process, okay? Suppose this is your plain text, and this plain text is encrypted through the encryption process to its corresponding ciphertext, and through a secure channel it will transfer to the receiver side. This is your sender side, this is your sender side, and this one is your receiver side, right? From this sender side, through a secure channel, it will transfer to the receiver side. Here suppose in case of symmetric cryptography, here the key is used KS for encryption and the same key is used for the decryption in case of symmetric cryptography system. But in case of asymmetric cryptography system, in case of asymmetric there are two key, one is public key and another one is your private key of a user, suppose named as A. And in case of asymmetric, the encryption is done by using the public key and the same pair of private key is used for the decryption. Or you can say the private key can be used for encrypting the data and the same pair of public key can be used for decrypting the data. So this is all about your cryptography system, symmetric, asymmetric cryptography system. We will learn more about some basic concept of network security in our next video. Hope you will understand. Thank you. Have a nice day.